Today I'm going to talk about four habits that have helped me achieve the 1% denomination, the top 1% denomination for my age group. Now let me start off by saying I am not in the top 1% of income earners. I am talking about the top 1% of net worth for my age group. And I am simply just basing off of this article of a very popular personal finance blogger known as Financial Samurai. So I'll link in the description below what his article is. And in there it says what the top 1% is for whatever your age group is. So real quick, I'll just throw up a screenshot of my personal capital, just so you can see that what I'm talking about, that is my net worth right now, recently, and that is in the 1% in my age category when you refer to that article I'm talking about. Now that doesn't really matter. What does matter is what kind of habits that you can develop in order to grow your net worth to be large, as I have, and I have developed early on and at a young age. And the first one that I really want to talk about is becoming a lifelong learner. Try to learn something new every day. That is something that I personally try to do, and that is something that I think that you should probably do and pretty much everyone should do. And it doesn't have to be something significant. You don't have to learn, you don't have to read an entire book every day. What I'm saying is you just need to try to learn something small, something every day, whether that be reading, whether that be watching a video, whether that be listening to a podcast. Try to just take something in every day that's going to improve your knowledge. Now, this doesn't have to be specific to personal finance, but me being a personal finance guy, I like to try to learn something new every day about personal finance or finance in general, whether that be about taxes, whether that be about investments, whether that be about frugality, whatever it may be. I just try to learn something small every day. Now, you don't have to be meticulous about this. You don't have to track every day that you've learned something or keep a record of anything like that. Just try to remember to seek something that you did not know and try to learn something new every day, no matter how small it may be. The next habit that I think has significantly gotten me to a high net worth is treating investments as if it is an expense. So a lot of people, they'll look at investments and say, okay, whatever I have left over at the end of the month, I'll put that into investments. And what ends up happening is they never have anything left over. It's funny how that happens. That's because they're not looking at investments as an expense or as a mandatory thing that you must do. And that's what I look at it as. I look at my investments as, okay, I have to pay this bill. Like, I have to do this. It's non-negotiable. I have to put money in investments every month. And I've been doing that every month since I first earned my first paycheck when I was 18 years old. Here I am at 25 years old and I still have that habit. I still look at my investments as, okay, this is non-negotiable. I have to pay this bill. I have to invest. There's no way around it. So if you start looking at investments in the same way, I think that it's going to do great things for your net worth in the future. The third habit that I have, and I've pretty much always have, and I can probably thank this to the military since I joined the military when I first got out of high school, is having structure in your life. So I think that having some kind of structure in your life is really important. I like to have things like a schedule or deadlines and things like that. I see those as commitments to myself, especially when I'm setting those schedules and I'm setting those commitments. Now, I'm not saying that everything in your life has to be extremely rigid and everything has to be planned out to the T. But what I personally like to do is I like to maybe plan my day ahead of time or plan my week or plan my month, plan my year. And not saying that I'm planning the entire thing out. I'm just saying that there might be a few main things that I want to get done or that I might want to get accomplished. So whether that be scheduling on a structure or structuring your goals in that way, I think it's important for you to have some kind of structure in the way you live your lifestyle. And that has certainly contributed very positively towards me growing my net worth. And I think it could also help you too if you develop that habit. Number four is focusing on the big picture. There are too many circumstances in life where people just focus on the small things. They let small setbacks completely destroy their goals and completely destroy their aspirations. And what I think you should do is instead you should focus on looking at the big picture. Instead of getting hung up on small setbacks, I try to focus on being positive about the small wins that I make. And small wins can be every day. And what really those small things do add up to be something big in the future. And changing your mindset to be more long-term. So stop thinking in the short term and start thinking more long-term. That's what really has gotten me to where I am today. And who knows 10 years from now where I'll be. But I think it's going to be pretty good, especially if I continue to keep these habits and continue to develop them even further. I'm a really strong believer in the 80-20 and the 20-80 rule. The 20-80 rule says 20% of your work gives you 80% of your results. there are just small things that you do that are pretty much the meat and potatoes of your goals and are what's going to get you to achieve your goals, whatever they may be, personal, finance, or otherwise. So those are my four habits that I think have really helped me to build my net worth to what it is right now. Let me know in the comments below if you know of any habits that can also help you achieve a great net worth or help you gain control of your finances. I'd really like to hear about them. And if you enjoyed this video, please like the video. I would really appreciate it. And subscribe to the channel because I want to put out more information and I want it to go straight to you as soon as I put it out. I really hope that this helped you out. Thank you guys for watching. I am Zach from OnCashflow.com and I'll see you next time.